morning, everyone, and welcome to another Slice of Heaven at 11 on this Thursday morning. I've been very busy this week clearing out some drawers and cupboards, and I came across a photograph that I saved, but I'd completely forgotten it. And I'm going to share it with you now. I think you'll be able to see it. You won't be able to read the beautiful copper plate writing underneath, but I'll read you the inscription. And this is the photograph. I hope you can see that. I think you can. And it says underneath, presented to Miss Clark on her leaving the town by the superintendent and members of her class in the Wesleyan Sunday School, with which school she has been usefully connected as a teacher for many years. April the 6th, 1876. In 1876, they were still using glass plates for photography, although they'd had photography studios for quite a while by then. So it must have been quite an occasion for them all to get into their best Sunday frocks and trot off to have their photograph taken. I did think usefully connected sounded rather restrained as a phrase, but thinking about it, of course, in Victorian Methodist Chapel, words were carefully chosen and usually fairly formal at that time. And you notice that Miss Clark didn't have a first name after all those years of working there. I think the fact that they got together to do the photograph for her shows the regard in which she was held. And I'm sure for her to take that keepsake away with her, it must have meant a lot, and to them as well. I attended a Sunday school, which was a Methodist Sunday school in a chapel in Derbyshire, when I was four until I was seven, and it was led by a very charismatic superintendent, and I still have vivid memories of that today, and the quiet, undemonstrative worship had a big impact on me and my early life. And of course, I still have vivid memories of the wit walks and riding around the village on a dray with the banners and everybody marching and the brass band leading us past the duck pond and back round to the chapel again. It did have quite an effect on me at that time. But usefully connected. At this time, of course, of lockdown, we are all usefully connected still in our own different ways, and we're all working together, whichever way suits us best, to support our community and each other. And I'm going to read this morning from 1 Corinthians, verse 4. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them. But it is to each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another gifts of healing by the one Spirit, and to another the working of miracles, to another prophecy, to another the discernment of spirits, and to another various kinds of tongues, and to another the interpretation of tongues. And all these are activated by one and the same Spirit, who allots to each one individually, just as the Spirit chooses. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ. For in the one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and we were all made to drink of one spirit. So we're all doing what we can in our own way during this difficult time. The annual report has recently been published and it shows the huge variety and the many different ways that folk support each other and support the parish. And so this morning I would like to thank everyone for all they do, for their commitment and the many hours spent enabling us to reach out to others. And of course we are continuing to reach out, even in these difficult times. We're continuing to provide packed lunches for vulnerable people on Fridays. And we provide the weekly fruit and veg for people being rehomed due to things like domestic violence. We're collecting material for scrubs and also toiletries and food donations on a Friday. People are phoning each other up, doing shopping, emailing, checking up on each other, and of course we're sharing our services online, as well as online baking, film club, quizzes and Desert Island Discs. Father Michael makes sure that those who are without the technology are still connected through mailing copies of the parish news and other information. Where people are not able to help in person, they're helping out financially if they're able to, and all of us are praying for each other and our communities at this time. We are all usefully connected. Rather than a dismissive phrase, I think a really powerful one. We are usefully connected to God, our parish, and each other. And as we connect through our prayers this morning, I would like to share a prayer for the Holy Spirit, written by Erasmus and updated a little. O Holy Spirit of God, who with your holy breath cleanses our hearts and minds, comforting us when we are sorrowful, leading us when we are lost, warming us when we are cold, knitting us together when we are apart, and enriching us with your many gifts, we ask you to increase each day the gifts you give us, and that with your light before us and within us, we may pass through the world without stumbling and without straying. Who lives and reigns with the Father and the Son, everlastingly. Amen. And this morning we pray for all those to whom we are usefully connected. And we ask God to strengthen and remember our ministry and leadership team. Our PCC. We will have to make decisions about how we reopen our churches, whether it's safe to do so, whether we wish to change what we have online for a diminished physical presence. No singing, no touching. Lord, we pray for all those making decisions about the way forward, for our parish, for our country. Give them wisdom and compassion at this time. Lord, we pray for all those working to support the community in our parish, in whichever way they can. And we pray for the communities that are still helping those who are at the margins of society. Lord, we ask you to refresh all those who are doing so much to serve and to care for others. Please add in any names that you would like to during our prayers for the sick and the dying. But we think particularly at this time for all those who are ill, at home or in hospital. For Ray Merrick and all those known to us. Lord, we ask you to remember all emergency workers, the NHS staff and schools opening again this week, coming to terms with a new normal for children and staff. And Lord, we ask you to remember all those who have died and those who support and minister to their grieving families. Give them peace and trust in your unfailing love at this time, O Lord. Lord, we ask you for ourselves, to refresh us, to renew our energy, and to work for you here in this place. We connect all our prayers together in our family prayer and say together, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. And we conclude with, Lord Jesus Christ, you have put your life into our hands. Now we put our lives into yours. Take us, renew us, and remake us. What we have been is past, and what we shall be through you still awaits us. Lead us on and take us with you. Amen. I hope we will all be usefully connected during this week and that you enjoy the rest of your Thursday. We'll listen to a little more of Philip Glass's music for the Rivers of Amazon. And perhaps another look at that Sunday school. Oh, sorry.